So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are important for each and every government exam of the Government of India or any other state government. Alright, so let's begin with the session, but before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Iska link you will find in the description, and here you will get the PDF of this session, and you can also connect me on Instagram. This is my Instagram ID. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question. Very, very important question guys. Definitely it will be comes in your exam. Chahe koi bhi exam ho, chahe ek number ka hai, is same question na hai, lekin isme se question aa sakta aapke exam mein. So consider the following statements with respect to the scheme for promotion of medical device parks, and you have to identify the correct statement. I know you must be wondering that this scheme was launched in the year 2020, then why we are discussing it right now in the year 2021 in the month of September. So this is because guys, the scheme was launched in the year 2020, I agree, but this has been notified in the month of September 2021. That's why we are discussing about this particular scheme. So now let's talk about something about this scheme. So remember guys, the objective of this scheme is to ensure easy access to standard testing and medical infrastructure facilities. Jo medical infrastructure facilities hai aur jo standard testing procedure hota hai medical devices ka, unke liye ek proper infrastructure this scheme will provide, and it will definitely ensure the reduction in the cost of medical devices. Jo medical devices hai unke cost mein रिडक्शन करेगा, डेफिनेटली इस स्कीम से ये ऑब्जेक्टिव पूरा होगा. एंड रिमेंबर, 4 मेडिकल डिवाइस पार्क्स विल बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड अक्रॉस द कंट्री. 4 मेडिकल डिवाइस पार्क्स एस्टैब्लिश किए जाएंगे, एंड दीज मेडिकल डिवाइस पार्क्स विल बी इन 4 स्टेट्स ऑफ हिमाचल प्रदेश, तमिलनाडु, मध्य प्रदेश एंड उत्तर प्रदेश. डू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दीज स्टेट्स ऑल्सो, एंड दीज स्टेट्स गाइज हैव बीन डिसाइडेड, यू नो, एक प्रॉपर असेसमेंट के बाद इन 4 स्टेट्स को सिलेक्ट किया गया था फॉर सेटिंग अप ऑफ द मेडिकल device parks, and some common infrastructure facilities will be provided in these medical device parks. All right, now talking more about this, so the scheme was launched in 2020, and this is for the duration of 5 years, starting from financial year 21 to financial year 25. Total financial outlays rupees 400 crores, and for one park maximum rupees 100 crore will be provided. Maximum 100 crores will be provided for a single park. So 4 parks means 400 crores, right? Funding pattern is 70:30 in the case of center and states, while 90:10 in the case of center, ratio, northeastern and hilly states. Now you must be wondering that where have the UTs gone? UTs kahan chale gaye? So UTs to hai nahi na, 4 states hain isme se, Himachal, Tamil Nadu, Madhya Pradesh and Uttar Pradesh are the normal states, while Himachal Pradesh comes under the category of northeastern hilly states. So for the Himachal Pradesh, any project in Himachal Pradesh, the government will bear the 90% of the project cost, subject to a maximum of 100 crore. While in the rest 3 states, the central government will bear the 70% of the project cost, subject to a maximum of again 100 crores. All right. Now in the infrastructure facilities hongi, theek hai, usme kya kya facilities hongi? These are some of the facilities that will be provided in these medical devices parks, like component testing center, electromagnetic interference and electromagnetic compatibility center, then 3D designing and printing for medical grade products, radiation testing center, radiology tube and piezoelectric crystals. This of course you need not remember, you do not have to remember, ye aapko yaad rakhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. This is just for the basic understanding that which facilities will be provided in these medical device parks. All right. So this was about this news guys, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement. So the scheme has been launched in 2021. No, the scheme was launched in the year 2020, last year. Total financial outlays rupees 400 crore. Yes, and for a single park, maximum 100 crores will be provided. So 4 parks means 400 crores. Tenure of the scheme is 2021 to 24-25. Yes, this is absolutely correct. 60% of the grants for setting up parks will be given by the center. No, not 60%. In case of a normal state, 70% will be provided by the central government, while in case of northeastern or Himalayan, which is only Himachal Pradesh in this case, 90% of the project cost will be borne by the central government, and the rest 10% will be borne by the state government. Okay, so this statement is incorrect. So 2 and 3 guys should be the correct answer. Option C should be the correct answer to this question. I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. Now guys, jo baki bache hue questions hai na, wo usme bahut zyada news nahi hai. They contain very less news, but yes, I will not say that these questions are not important. These are equally important. जो कि हमने पहली वाली न्यूज में थी उतनी ही इंपॉर्टेंट है, बस उसमें उतनी ज्यादा डिटेल में हमें नहीं जाना. We do not have to go into that much details in the upcoming news that जो कि हम क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 से आगे पढ़ेंगे. According to mineral production index for the month of June 2021, mineral production was how much percent higher as compared to the level in the month of June 2020? You have to fill the gap. So basically June 2020 में जो भी mineral production का percentage था, जो भी total mineral production थी, उससे कितना percent higher है in the month of June 2021? Alright, so let's talk about this mineral production index. And remember, you have to remember only 3 things about this mineral production index. Only 3 things. And of course, this production has been released by Ministry of Mines. Ministry of Mines. Ministry of Mines is headed by Prahlad Joshi. He's also the Minister of Coal and also the Minister of Parliamentary Affairs. And which is his Lok Sabha constituency? Dharwad. Dharwad is his Lok Sabha constituency, which is of course in Karnataka. So these are the 3 facts that you have to remember about this mineral production index. Number 1 is that the mineral production was 23.1% higher as compared to the corresponding period of the financial of the previous financial year. All right, the maximum increase which was in the production of chromite, which is 130.3%, and there were basically is index ke according aise bhi kuch minerals hai jisme negative growth hai. There are certain minerals which have negative growth rate, and among them the highest negative growth was of diamond, which is -99.4%. Negative growth of 99.4%. All right, so matlab diamond to matlab almost uski jo production thi wo half se bhi zyada kam ho gayi hai. Theek hai, so this was about this news, and here they are asking about the total production. So that's 23.1% higher as compared to the corresponding period of the previous financial year. All right, so now let's come to question number 3. With which power company Abdul Latif Jameel Poverty Action Lab South Asia, this is guys a non profit organization, Abdul Latif Jameel Poverty Action Lab South Asia has partnered to create an annual database assessment of 79 public and private power distribution companies, which in short is DISCOMs, across the country. So is Poverty Action Lab साउथ इंडिया ब्रांच के साथ कौन सी पावर कंपनी ने एक डेटा असेसमेंट रिपोर्ट बनाने की सोची है ऑफ द पावर पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट पावर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनी. सो द करेक्ट आंसर लेट मी टेल यू दिस, आरईसी रूरल इलेक्ट्रिफिकेशन कॉर्पोरेशन लिमिटेड, आरईसी लिमिटेड इज द करेक्ट आंसर, बट वी हैव टू डिस्कस मोर अबाउट दिस न्यूज. सो रिमेंबर आरईसी लिमिटेड हैज पार्टनर्ड विद दिस कंपनी, डू रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ दिस कंपनी, अब्दुल लतीफ जमील पॉवर्टी एक्शन लैब साउथ एशिया. So they you know has they both have partnered with each other to create an annual database assessment of 79 public and private power distribution companies across the country, and this partnership guys will definitely improve the service delivery of the power DISCOMs, and also it will ensure the proper electricity to the citizens of the country. And under this collaboration, the existing data, jo bhi existing data hai, that will be used by these two agencies, REC and Poverty Action Lab, for what? To diagnose trends and identify the gaps in the quality of services which is being supplied by the power distribution companies. Also, these data sets will be used to create a consumer service index. A consumer service index will be created, and then accordingly the required things, the required guidance will be provided to the power distribution companies, and of course JPL South Asia will provide technical research support. Okay, so this was about this news, and hence guys, so let's come back to question number 1 again. Yes, question number 3, the correct answer is what? REC Limited. Option B is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 4. Which of the following organizations was announced as the winner in the best use of digital technology category at the SIPS Excellence in Procurement Awards 2021? Now in this news also you just have to remember the name of the organization, which organization has won this award. Other than this, other things are not important for the exam. So do remember that this organization, guys, is a government e-marketplace. Government e-marketplace, option D. Now, what is this government e-marketplace? चलो अभी आगे बात करेंगे, पहले थोड़ा सा और डिस्कस कर लेते हैं. So remember, what is this CIPS? CIPS stands for Chartered Institute of Procurement and Supply. Chartered Institute of Procurement and Supply, which is a London-based non-profit organization. And this organization, remember guys, is dedicated to the promoting good practices in procurement and supply. Procurement and supply के area में good practices को promote करने के लिए ये organization dedicated है, ये organization काम करता है. And remember, it is a London-based non-profit organization. And under CIPS Excellence in Procurement Award, under the category of best use of digital technology, this government e-marketplace has got this prize. Okay, do remember these things. And talking about government e-marketplace, so as you all know, it was launched in the year 2016 by Ministry of Commerce and Industry, and it is basically a procurement portal. It is a national public procurement portal to facilitate online procurement of commonly used goods and services which are required by the central departments, state governments, public sector enterprise, public sector undertakings, etc. Okay. And at present, JIM has more than 30 lakh products over rupees 10 lakh crore worth of transaction. Alright. So now let's come back to the question. So yes, the correct answer is what? Government e-marketplace. Option D is the correct answer. Do remember this fact that this government e-marketplace was launched in the year 2016 by Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. Moving ahead to question number 5. Where was People's Plan Campaign 2021, which is titled as Sabki Yojana Sabka Vikas for Northeastern States, organized by Ministry of Panchayati Raj. Now, who is the Minister of Panchayati Raj? So, Minister for Rural Development and Panchayati Raj is Mr. Giriraj Singh. Giriraj Singh is the Minister of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj. So, this People's Plan Campaign 2021 has been launched for the Northeastern States with the under the title Sabki Yojana Sabka Vikas in Guwahati. This has been launched in Guwahati, and Guwahati, of course, we all know is in Assam. And remember, this campaign was launched for inclusive and holistic preparation of Gram Panchayat Development Plans. Gram Panchayat Development Plan ke inclusive development ke liye this campaign has been launched. And remember, there is an institute where this campaign was launched, which is known as National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj Northeastern Center, which is located in Guwahati. And the broad objective of this campaign include the strengthening of elected representatives and self-help groups. Okay, so isme itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Isme question agar aaya to yahi aayega that this People's Plan Campaign 2020 organized for Northeastern states. So it was organized in National Institute of Panchayati Raj and Rural Development in Guwahati. Okay, so therefore, guys, the correct answer is what? Option E, Guwahati. Guwahati is the correct answer, and Guwahati is in Assam. And now let's move ahead to question number 6, which is the last question for today. With which of the following organizations, Ministry of Education, headed by Dharmendra Pradhan, he is also the Minister of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, has organized the national webinar on empowering women, building gender parity. So remember, is news mein sirf itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada nahi padhna hai. एक वेबिनार था ऑन एम्पावरिंग वुमेन, एंड देर इज नथिंग इंपॉर्टेंट इन दिस वेबिनार. देर इज नो की वर्ड, देर इज नो की पॉइंट फ्रॉम दिस नेशनल वेबिनार. इट वॉज जस्ट अ वेबिनार फॉर वुमेन एम्पावरमेंट एंड फॉर बिल्डिंग जेंडर पैरिटी. ओके, इट वॉज ऑर्गेनाइज बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन इन कोलाबोरेशन विद UGC. ऑप्शन बी, UGC इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ओके, सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड UGC. बस इसमें इतना सा याद रखना, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन ने UGC के साथ मिलकर यह वेबिनार ऑर्गेनाइज किया था. ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन गाइज. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स, यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.